A number of reports has confirmed the proliferation of anti-Muslim narratives across European countries, and in this regard, France is no exception. And despite the decline in anti-Muslim acts observed in 2016, the figures confirm an overall upward trend in these acts. And based on our research findings, we recommend that the following measures be taken in order to counter anti-Muslim narratives effectively. First, dissociate Islam from terrorism in the political discourse. Hate narratives that associate Islam with terrorism are a recurrent phenomenon and have been around for a long time. They fuel the idea that Muslims challenge domestic security and represent a potential terrorism threat. It is therefore advisable to deploy strong and inclusive political discourses and avoid inflammatory language. Political discourses should also clearly distinguish between Islam and Islamism and avoid linking domestic Islam-related issues with international politics. It is also necessary to move away from a security-centered approach to Islam and focus on policies that have a long-term impact on Muslim youth and facilitate their access to education and employment. Second, encourage media to adopt a more nuanced approach to Islam-related issues. Media often portray Muslims as a homogeneous group whose religious and cultural traditions compromise secular and republican values. There is a need to engage in a fact-based public debate on Islam and move beyond the cliché about incompatibility of Islam and French values, or whatever that means. Media professionals should also be encouraged to deal with sensitive topics responsibly and avoid sensationalism. Third, increase social involvement of Muslim women. The public discourse on Muslim women is heavily influenced by imbalanced reporting that produces distorted images. They are perceived as domestic and family-oriented. In reality, it is the coercive measures and laws that limit their access to labor market, leisure facilities, healthcare, etc., that aggravate their economic and social isolation. Therefore, projects and schemes striving to increase their integration into the workforce and develop their economic potential, that should be encouraged. It is essential to accept Muslim women as professionals who contribute to the society economically. Fourth, reframe the public debate on integration. There is a constant pressure on Muslims to show no signs of foreign culture and religion, and when they do, they are perceived as illegitimate and not fully French. The principle of secularism, laïcité, is often used to support these allegations. The legal framework that governs laïcité is often misinterpreted. It is incumbent upon all stakeholders to ensure that it is respected and does not exclude Muslims. There is also an urgent need to engage in a dispassionate debate about French citizenship model and the French identity, while ensuring it will not get sidetracked by electioneering and partisan interests. And fifth, acknowledge discrimination against Muslims. There is an ongoing debate about the validity, well, in France, about the validity of the term Islamophobia. Although it is widely used by practitioners and Muslim population themselves, it's not used by the institutions. Consenting to its use is a way of recognizing the scope and seriousness of the problem. To obtain the reliable data allowing for tailored responses to Islamophobia, it is also essential to improve monitoring and reporting of Islamophobic incidents. This entails establishing efficient monitoring mechanisms and developing capacity of the law enforcement officials to accurately record these incidents. It is also necessary to develop campaigns and outreach activities to encourage victims to report those incidents. Authorities should also clearly condemn Islamophobia and step up efforts to ensure equal access to justice for victims of those acts. Thank you.